Oh, thanks. There are moments when I can hear you breathing. Like, it's been so many years where it's been so noisy, and like even at theaters, like where people are just like talking or drunk or just like cheering and yelling, and like there are moments where where I'm like, and this is all I hear is. It's amazing. I feel very powerful. Sometimes when we're playing, I want to say something now too.
Yeah.
That's when the power of that comes. Sometimes I really like this show. Like I like.
Love you, Sarah!
Thank you. I like. Okay, fine. Some of you.
Everybody likes you equally.
No, no, it's fine. Keep it more pop. I don't care. It doesn't matter.
No.
Just, you know, like, show your love. If you're a Tegan fan, you can donate to the Tegan and Sarah Foundation at the Tegan and Sarah Foundation table. If you're a fan of Sarah, you can donate across the aisle at the Tegan and Sarah merch area. That's really the only way we can really figure out who's the proper. A dollar could change how we feel about ourselves. What's that now? Mine? I don't have cats. This has come up a few times lately. Even by people I know who are like, I love your cats. I'm like, they're Sarah's cats. Oh, I thought they were both of your cats. Why? We're 37. I don't know if you should have cats. Did you think we were hanging out and bringing the cats to hang out with each other too? Some people are like, yeah. Also strange. Yeah, cats hate other people's cats. Like, that's part of why I like them. What's sad is that what I'm starting to establish is that either something really terrible has gone on, which is that somehow I thought everybody knew we were twins, and then, in fact, people didn't know. And then another thing may have happened. I'm just going to clean up my area here. Just Thomas, she's just, like, so blasé. She's like, anyways, let me fucking tell you something about Sarah's cats while I clean up my area. Like, she's so pissed about it, she's like, I guess I'll take this chance to pick up all these guitar picks I dropped.
Okay, so worst case scenario, we live together. Even though we're 37.
Which we do a lot of times.
Yeah, don't say that.
On the tour bus,
we live confused. Worst case scenario, we live together at 37. That's what people think. Best case scenario, they think we're friends with our cats, like, and then we socialize them together, like, I'm all like, all right, Holiday, into the cat carrier, and I go over to Sarah's and let Holiday and Nikki play together. It's strange, but it's the best case scenario here. Because the really, really, really scary case scenario is that you thought we were together. This whole time. Anyway, I run into people all the time on the street, and they're like, I love your cats, and I'm like, they're Sarah's cats, and it's a weird feeling because I really want cats, and so it's like every day I'm reminded, like, she might as well have a baby. Because, you know, people volunteer to you, like, when they say, do you want kids? And you say that you don't want kids, and then they're like, oh, that's a mistake. You want it. You want a carrier. No, actually, I don't. Anyway, I'm riffing, I'm sorry.
But thanks,
Sarah's cats are great.
Yeah, they're cool. The cool part about cats is that they have no idea what's going on. Like, they, sometimes this is, okay, I try to explain this sometimes, but, like, I wish the cats knew who I was as a person. Like, that I was, like, I got home tonight and Holiday was like, meow, 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 meow. Like, how long is that, you know? Like, not in English. Like, I'm not psychotic, you know? Like, but, like,
I don't understand.
Like, I just, sometimes she, like, the guy, the boy cat is, he's an idiot, it doesn't matter, but the girl cat, like, Holiday is so smart.
She's like
so
one smart. Guy in the audience just go, ooh. That happened, can I imagine it, or did that
happen? I actually, you know what, I'm rooting for men, you know, I've always really loved men and was rooting for them, and then I got a male cat and I was like, its most basic level, all he cares about is himself, his dick, his food,
and then Holiday doing things for him, you know? Like, he's just always like, come on. He's like, comes over and he's like, lick me, you know? And then she's like, puts up with it for like 2 seconds and she just fucking kisses and he just runs off, you know? And I'm like, that might be what the most basic, that might be the most basic human instincts that I'm seeing there. I don't know. Okay, sorry. So, the thing I was gonna say about Holiday, the smart one, sometimes she looks so smart and she's like watching me do things, so I just wish I could come home from tonight and she could just like acknowledge, like, hey, I know you're out there working really hard, and like you worked 3 weeks on this show and you were really stressed out and you were in bed early all the time, which really suited me because I generally like to go to bed around 9, so that worked really well. And then you were up early with like vicious anxiety, and that helps me because then I get to go outside a little earlier than normal. Like, I just wish she would say that to me, like even just in her eyes, you know? Just, I guess that's what it's like to have a kid, where you just want them to acknowledge you. Yeah. So and your immortality. Okay, sorry. Yeah. That was weird. Sorry about that. I'm not stoned or anything. I just. Oh, that's cool. I feel it, you know? There's only a couple songs left. Yeah. I know, that's why I was dropping. But it's important to state that, so I want to just really awkwardly shift gears and introduce our band, because... They're male, so it's... Sorry, I know, but there's really no other time to do it. Yeah. It's now or never, so... We've known this guy for a really long time. He's absolutely killing it up here. He came in, flew halfway across the earth and felt like, and he walked in and we were all like, what's up? And then we were like, put that guitar on and get to work. And he hasn't stopped since. And he's just such a lovely human being. Can you please give a huge round of applause to Tim? Number one? Yeah, what else are you gonna say? He's gonna turn on you in a second. Okay. This guy over here, he's been touring with us since we started the Love You to Death campaign. And we were so excited to have him join the band because he's just like one of the nicest people. I interviewed with him. He left Sarah's house and the cats where they live with Sarah alone. And we were like, oh my God, we have to get him to play with us. He's just the kindest, sweetest, loveliest person. And I can say after 18 months plus, that has not changed one bit. And we're so glad you got to do this last tour with us. This is Gabriel McNair. Bragging, informing, letting Gabe know that this was coming all year. And we're like, wait till we go out without the band and the tracks, and we never shut up, and he was like, oh, you bet, it'll be great. Like, day three at the rehearsal spot, because we do this at rehearsal. This is like, literally without an audience. We do this. We talk and talk and talk. Facing a wall, we never talk to them. And, not for practice, just because we find it so entertaining to hear ourselves speak. But anyway, but day three, we all got those like pads that people who work like cashiers stand on because they were so tired and they were getting like shin splints. You know what I'm talking about? Those rubber pads. Some people just were like, is that me? I'm not going to make eye contact with them again, but I'm going to quickly stand by and see if they're smiling now that I talked about them. We're going to play 4 more songs and then we'll be out of your hair. But this has been really, 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 really fun, and we'll talk to you soon, unfortunately, or fortunately, for those who are.